we were at 1.7 to 1.9% organic matter. This past fall, as we do soil tests, when you're kind of go out and speak in that, you tend to get a lot of naysayers. So one thing on our operation, we've always had an open door policy. Anyone can come to our operation at any time, see what we're doing. Because of this, I get a lot of scientists coming, taking soil tests, doing different tests on our operation, and I welcome, because I'm not smart enough to figure out exactly the intricacies of what's happening to our soils and on our operation. Let them figure it out and see for, they can explain it to me. We've moved our organic matter levels up now to 4.7 to 5.3%. So we've made a significant increase, but I'm still embarrassed because that's still a degraded state. Our North Dakota prairie soils back 200 years ago were probably in the 10 to 15% organic matter level, you know, and we've degraded it to that. I've got a long way to go to regenerate these soils. This here was put together by Dr. Mark Liebig, soil scientist, ARS Mandan, North Dakota, and it's simply for every organic matter percent increase, how much water holding capacity would you have? I mentioned when we started we were under 2%, so we have silt loams, which is the middle column, means I could store about 2.4 inches of water per foot in the top 4 feet of the soil profile. Now I'm up over 5%, I've increased that to 4 inches. Moisture is no longer a limiting factor on my operation, because if we get moisture, I can not only infiltrate it into the soil, I can store it in the soil, because we've improved soil health. That's why we need to focus on the resources. This is an actual scenario of one of my fields. Take our soil tests up there, they're taken in early fall. This is immediately following a cover crop, warm season cover crop like the one I showed you. This soil test shows, and I know it's too small to read, but that there's only 10 pounds of nitrogen in the top 2 feet of that soil profile. Okay? How much corn are you going to grow on 10 pounds of N? No takers. Well, here's us planting into that type of residue. And, you know, that's a fairly thick residue there. We don't use trash whippers. To me, that's way too much tillage. On your left, that was already planted. On the right, it's not planted. Okay? Corn doesn't have any problem coming up through that residue. When I say I'm a zero tiller, I mean I'm a zero tiller. We don't do any tillage of any kind. Notice I wasn't using the row markers on that plant. That's too much tillage in my book. The only tillage I want done is by the earthworms and other macroorganisms. Now, remember this picture. I'm going to jump off it here for a minute because I didn't know where to add these other slides, but a lot of people think that I'm not all right upstairs, and I'm going to prove that to you right here. This is my no-till garden because I had it challenged to me, but Gabe, I had an irrigator come up and say, you know, I grow potatoes. You can't grow no-till potatoes. Right down that center strip, those are no-till potatoes. Paul and I, in the spring, all we do is go out there with a bucket of seed potatoes, throw them on the surface of the ground, start the tractor, roll a round bale of hay right over the top of them. There's all my potatoes, right under the hay. When I say I'm a no-tiller, don't challenge me that I can't do something, because I'll prove to you I can. You know, I'm not afraid of failure. But that's how we no-till potatoes in. The rest of that picture there, that's all... I had the idea last winter. You know, every year we try and see just how crazy an idea we can try. And one thing you don't see, at the end of this field, that's Interstate 94, the main highway going through North Dakota. I try and do all these right along the highway. So, for instance, the first year I planted sun hemp, boy, the highway, highway patrol really liked that, I tell you, because there was how many... almost accidents where people lock it up just to see that what was really growing in that field. I had the idea this last winter, you know, this is